Hello everyone. So today we'll see another program from your journal. That is the 8th one. Okay. So it is a VB form, guys. And here the task given to you is you have to draw, okay, a particular shape, right? Taking 3 points. So you have to draw a shape, and then in that shape you have to fill, okay, the color, right? So let us see what are the main components of this project, or let us see what main tools we are going to take here, right? Okay, see guys, so this is a VB form which you can see here, and this area is a particular area is called as what? You have taken one panel. Okay, so this particular area is a panel. So inside this panel you're going to draw the shape, right? You're going to take some points and you're going to connect it and draw the shape. So here you can see that there are totally 6 labels. That is label number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So we have 6 labels. We have 4 buttons, 1, 2, 3, and 4, right? So this is a panel. So along with this 6 labels, 4 button, you are going to take one panel, right? So that is the designing part. So, and when you take a designing, this is the properties part which we are going to set. All right. So now let us move towards the procedure of doing this program, guys. The first thing is, let us start with the Visual Studio. Once when you start the Visual Studio, you have to go for File, New Project, right? So here you have to do it as a project, not as a website. Okay. So File, New Project. Then you can select a location where you want to set this project. Suppose I will take SNAE, right? And then I'll select this folder and I will take it as a Windows Form Application 1. Okay. And then first thing is choose Visual C Sharp also, Windows Form Application, right? And then click on OK. So you can see that the form is visible to you, right? So this simple form is visible to you. What is the next thing that we have to do, guys? We have to practice, right? We have to practice the properties which are shown to you, right? Now, let me take both the windows simultaneously so that we can set the properties, right? So once when you see here what part of properties we want to set, yes, see there are 2 scripts. One is your form, right? And one screen I'm taking it for displaying the properties, right? So let me go with this screen first. All right. So guys, first we have to take one panel here, right? Where you can see it is there in the container, right? So let us go to panel. Just see where the panel exists, students. See. Yes, it is in the container. So take a panel. Yes. And then drag it a little bit, like little bit, to the 50% portion, right? So this is the panel. Next tool that I have to take is a color dialog box, okay? So which is there in the dialogs, right? So take a color dialog, just draw it and drop it, fine? All right. Now the next thing that I have to do is, students, I have to take 6 labels back to back, right? So this is label number 1, okay? Label number 2, label number 3, label number 4, okay, label number 5, label number 6, that's it, right? Now I have to take 4 buttons, guys. So button number 1, so button number 2, then take button number 3, and then take button number 4, that's it. So this is the designing part, students, right? Now we have to move towards setting the properties, right? So here I will just open the properties window, right? I'll close the tools, right? Now I select this panel, guys. See, I have selected panel. And there inside the panel, I will take a back color. I will set it as a button highlight. So this is the color which I want to set. Now I will set the properties one by one, students, okay? So let me open the journal for you so that these properties are available for you during the designing also, right? Okay. So now, while setting the properties, students, okay, so let me open this window for you. See, we are going to set properties in this way. So this is our table, right, where the properties are given. So you can see this panel backlight, what is done, color dialog. You're not going to set any properties for label one students. See here, for label one, these are the ID and these are the text values. So according to this, we are going to set the values. Clear? Now I'll come back to label number one students. Okay, I'll just come back to label number one. And according to this, let us set the properties, right? So according to what we have taken here, let me set the properties, right? So for label number one, ID, right? So select label number one, select ID. What is the ID, students? Okay, so here I will come that ID in project, it comes as a what? Name, not as an ID, right? You can see here, label one, I'm keeping it as a label one default only. Then I will go for next content, that is the text, student. So text, I will just clear it, right? And I will make it as vertex number one, right? So this is the properties which I want to set for label number one. Similarly, come to label number two. So label number two, right? In label number two, you can see that the name given for this is word. V-E-R-D, small, just take it as a small case, word one, right? And then text given for this is what, students? V-E-R-T-E-X, vertex one, right? Then come to label number three, guys, okay? Let us come to label number three. So when you come to label number three, you can see that the name is label number three, okay? And the text, what is the text? Vertex two, so V-E-R-T-E-X, so vertex number two, right? Now, let us go to label number four, guys. So label number four, what is the name given? Name given is what? V-E-R-T, vert two, right? So it is vert two. And then when you come here, the text, guys, what is the text? See, the text is what? V-E-R-T-E-X, vertex number two. Yes, let's go to label number five. So you can see that the label number five, okay? So for label number five, the name is label number five. Text given is what, students? It is vertex, V-E-R-T-E-X. So that is vertex number three. Clear? Let's go to label number six. So for label number six, guys, you can see that the name, what is the name given? The name given is what, V-E-R-T, word three, okay? And then you are setting the text. So set the text for what, students? V-E-R-T-E-X, vertex number three. All right, so this is how we set the properties for all the labels, right? Now let us go to the buttons. So for button, you are keeping all the text default, right? Keep the text, all the IDs are kept as what? Default, right? Then we go for what? Text. So here you can take it as what, guys? Select, S-E-L-E-T, select, right? Okay, then select button number two. So for button number two, again, you can see that the name, keep it as a default. Text, you can take it as what? Select, right? Then going for button number three, guys, keep it as a default name. Just to change the text, okay? And make it as select, right? Go for button number four, okay? And just change ID, that is name as well as text forward, guys. Will keep your F capital, right? So this is how I work with my properties window, guys, right? This is how I just set my properties, all right? So here you can see that all the properties now we have set carefully, right? Okay, so save your file whenever it's needed. Just have a check, vertex one, vertex two, vertex two, vertex two, right? Then vertex three, word three, okay? Everything is set. Now the next thing is that we have to generate the code box. So now for that, what you have to do, guys, first go for a panel one and just go for events. So in that event, you can find that there is a mouse down event. Okay, so just double click on that. So when you double click on that, the mouse down code box is generated, guys. Okay, you can see that the mouse down code box is generated, right? Come back to the form design, guys. Okay. And now go on generating the code for each button, like button number one, okay, go back to form. Button number two, go back to form. Button number three, go back to form and take button number four. So in this way, the main code box is generated, students, okay? And remember that this code box has to be generated wherein you have to include your code. So if you fail, right, if you fail to include this code, guys, what will happen there? Whatever code you are going to take, that will not work correctly, right? Now let me open your journal, students, and in that journal what I will do is I'll just go for the code. Okay, so just give me a second, we'll go for that code. See, where is that? It's here. Okay, so let me go to this, right? Now you can see that in panel, mouse down, this all amount of code is there. Before that, I have to copy some code like initialize components and in that the graphics. Okay, so I will take this code from your journal, students. Okay, let us come back to the coding part. Yes, see. So here few lines of code I have to include, students, right? So I'd included that. So now you can see here the graphics, okay, which is included. All the declaration of variable happens here. Okay, after the declaration of variable, some part of code which has to be included in the panel one, right? So let us take this code. Okay, so this part of code I'm taking here, which should be written inside the paint event, right? So here I go and I take the code for paint event, guys. Clear? Okay. So after taking the code for paint event, let's move back. Okay, so this is your form design. So just check whether all the properties are set properly or not. Okay, so this is our world one. This is our world two, right? Okay. This is our label number three. This is a world one. Okay. This is world two. So here you can see that in this properties, guys. Okay. So what has happened is world, we have taken it as what, students? Capital, right? So we have taken it as a capital, right? So when I go to code here, right? So there, if I have taken capital, you can take capital. If I have taken small, you can just go for small, right? Now, let's go for the code for button number one, students. Just take the code for button number one, okay? And put it in your button number one, okay? So this is the code for your button number one, right? So save your code simultaneously, guys. Now you can see that same coding we have to take for one button number two, okay? So just ping it into button number two, right? All right. So in this way, just go on writing the code, okay? So just take button number three, just put this code into the button number three, right? All right, now let us take the code for fill, okay, and just take it and put inside the fill. All right, so this is the coding part, students, right? So in this way you have to set the properties, okay, and run the code. So when I run this code, okay, you can see that there are some errors, right? So what is expected? Semicolon is expected. Just do that, okay, save it. And when you rerun this code, right? So after running the code, you can see, guys, so when I take vertex one, okay, and then I take vertex two, I take vertex three, right? And then when I click on fill, you can see that the black color will appear and then it will also take the selected color. So how will this output run, guys? How this output will run, can you tell me? See. So let us run it once again, then I will tell you how it gets executed, right? So when I press on this select, vertex one is selected, it is not visible. So the X and Y values are visible here. When I take vertex two, okay, the second and first vertex are connected. When I take vertex three, guys, okay, first and third, second and third vertex is connected. And then when I go on fill, default black color is filled in that. Okay. And when I select the color and go on OK, and then again click on fill, automatically that will fill the color. Clear, guys? So this is all about the execution part, right? Now, what about coding part? Just see here, guys. So what I have to do is, initially you can see, right? I have to create a form, initialize all the components, all the graphics. So these are all the variables which I want to declare. And I'm taking a new pen, brushes of black. I'm taking a black pen at the beginning, guys, okay? So when I take this black pen at the beginning, right? In the mouse down, so inside the panel, what you're going to do, students, inside that panel, okay? Inside that panel, you're going to draw it. So V1, you're going to form a point of X, Y, and there inside that vertex, it will display the X and Y value. Similarly with V2. So vertex V2 and its selected points. And then you draw a line between what V1 and V2 by this P. P is nothing but a black pen. And the width of that pen is 5. So similarly, give third point. After giving third point, connect V2, V3, V1, V3, right? And after this drawing is over, again, you can set it to what, guys? False, right? Now, after this, what happens, guys? When you go for button number one, when you click on button number one, right? When you click on this button number one, okay? So the panel one dot cursor, a cross mark will appear. V2, V3, all these will become true after you select the button. And then finally, the color dialog box will fill this with the color. Clear, guys? So this is the concept. Right, so just please try that in your lab, okay, and just execute it properly.